Hey, this is Paul from Cannibal Corpse, and you are watching Metal Injection.
Hey, what's up? This is Scarlett. I am at the Rockstar Mayhem Festival with Metal Injection, and I am here with Paul
from Cannibal Corpse.
I am the Black Gods of the Night. This shade's nice because it's pretty hot here.
It is very nice. I wish we could stay in the shade all day. Unfortunately, you know, it's a hot day in the summer in Oklahoma City, but that's what it's been all tour. So, you know, it is what it is.
Yeah. Tell me about the hottest, the crazy. You guys have experienced some weather on this tour, I understand. Tell me about that.
Oh, yes, definitely. We started out west, and definitely the hottest day of the tour was in Phoenix. I think it hit about 116, and it was just, it's ridiculous. I mean, nobody should be outside doing things in heat like that,
this
you know?
So
it was just a whirlwind of a day. I mean, kind of crazy, though, when we went to play our show, a big dust storm came through, and I don't know if it was a good thing or a bad thing. The temperature dropped by about 20 degrees, but we played basically in a dust cloud, you know? So that was kind of interesting, I guess. You know, that's a first for Cannibal Corpse. So yeah, we've had some interesting weather, mostly just dealing with some extreme heat. But that was probably the craziest day of the tour so far.
Was it like playing in a metal video, like, and just like this dust is like rolling around?
Yeah, kind of. I mean, it was actually a little hard to breathe. I remember towards the end of the set a couple of times just having to, you know, kind of cough up, going, what the hell are we going to make it through this? But yeah, it was a little surreal, I guess. So.
Yeah, awesome. Okay, so this tour is very diverse. It brings a lot of different genres of music, you know, to the plate. And how do you think, with that diverse crowd, Cannibal Corpse has been, what kind of a reaction do you think you guys have been getting?
Oh, it's been amazing. I mean, really, when you look at the package, it's a diverse metal package, but it's pretty aggressive metal package, you know. So we've been having great responses, great turnouts with our fans, kind of a thing. Of course, we're probably playing in front of a lot of new fans and a lot of people that never seen us before, but I mean, the reaction's been phenomenal. You know, the stage setup is a little bit different for this situation, but normally what was happening is the amphitheater show was going on and the Jägermeister Hot Topic stages were out in the parking lot, kind of a thing. And I know it's, like I said, a little setup different here in Oklahoma City, but you know, we would close out the Hot Topic stage and close out the parking lot, and then they'd open the amphitheater, and we'd have, you know, thousands of people there watching us, kind of a thing, and some great pits for, you know, for our songs. So I think it's been an overwhelmingly positive scenario for us on this tour. It's been great.
Good. So Mayhem's been well. I know you guys have been touring on your newest release in February, Evisceration Plague. Been touring since April. That tour was solid. I caught a show in Tulsa,
yes,
in a little bitty venue, and the pit was just still huge. How do you think that tour went?
Oh, that was great. That was a good little, you know, secondary market kind of a tour, of course. That was a lot of fun. We played a lot of places that we've never played before or maybe haven't played in years, you know.
Right.
So that was a lot of fun. It was a great tour, great bill on that, and, you know, it was just a good precursor, I guess, leading up to this tour, so,
right.
Yeah.
Awesome. Were you stoked when you got the call to get on this tour? Where were you guys? What were you guys doing?
Well, I mean, this has been in the works for a while. So obviously with management, there was a few options, to be done or to be had, kind of a thing, way back when, you know, they're sorting all this stuff out, because, you know, things like this get sorted out months in advance, of
right.
course. So we had a few little, options, kind of a thing. We knew this one was possibly available, so we just really told management to, you know, let's try to get this one done, of course.
Right.
You know, this is the tour we want to be on, and luckily it happened, and I can't really fully remember what we were doing or anything, like when it was, say, finalized. I mean, I just remember we were home, you know, rehearsing or what have you, getting ready to do whatever, and, you know, it just all came together, and then when we finally knew it was going to happen, of course, we were just thrilled and just like, yes, finally, you know, being on a tour with Slayer and, you know, on a big production running through America. We've just never did anything like this. Our last outing like this was the Sounds of the Underground in 2006, and that was really small in comparison to this tour.
Right.
So it was finally good to be on like one of these rolling outdoor festivals. And, you know, like I said, when we knew that the bill was going to be what it was, it just, wow, this is an awesome metal package. And we were definitely very excited to be a part of this.
Awesome. So, Evisceration Plague is actually your highest debut on the Billboard charts yet, so that's rad. and you guys came out with a comic book for it, correct? Now, what was the idea behind that?
Well, it was actually supposed to be released kind of like coinciding with Evisceration Plague back in February. Unfortunately, it kind of all fell through for that with the economy at the time, and a company that was supposed to take care of that, the people in charge were let go, what have you. But I think management, and we still thought it was a great idea to do this comic book, so we just kind of went on our own and said, well, you know what, let's have Vince Locke do the whole thing, because he was only going to be a part of it, actually. They were going to have different artists and all this kind of a thing. So we just got a hold of Vince and say, hey, maybe Vince can just do the whole thing, you know, and he was able to, you know, to do it, and it turned out amazing. I mean, it's for sale now at the Hot Topic booth on the tour here, obviously the last day of the tour. I know it'll be sold through Hot Topic, and, you know, we'll probably be able to sell it in our store and all that, but it's a 96-page, basically it's a graphic novel. It's all glossy. It's just a visual of every song on Evisceration Plague. So it's basically all it done to the lyrics. So when you're, you know, going through it, Priests of Sodom, you're just reading the lyrics, and it's Vince's visuals that he put to our lyrics.
Okay.
So it really turned out great. I mean, the fans seemed to like it. We thought it, you know, think it turned out awesome. So, you know, we're selling a lot of those. So, you know, it seems to be a winner. So.
Killer. I'm going to have to check that out now. Awesome. Well, do you have any parting words?
Well, just thank you for the interview. I appreciate it. And thanks for the fans of Cannibal Corpse and Death Metal. If it wasn't for you guys, we wouldn't be here. So keep it brutal.